Very professional, Keith.
Alex, I'm not looking. There's my camera. Look, I'm not looking. I'm not looking.
Look at that naked man over here. So you're safe.
She always does.
Let's have a look.
Look at the proper camera.
Yeah, it looks really expensive camera.
Yeah.
brave. Our daughter Sarah, I think she looks absolutely fantastic. Some part in Sarah Jobs' life, whether it's a small part or a big part, no value because of that. Because great friends are very happy to see more here. I'm sure that Annika, Fiona, Susan, Ruth unfortunately can't be here, Jane, Alison, Joanna, and Charlie in particular, would remember that we'd never had a boxing day in our house. Sarah moved in with John. No, it was still Sarah's here. But our house, but Mark and I loved it. We never had any trouble, and it was wonderful to watch Sarah and her friends grow up in front of our eyes. From young children to extremely beautiful women. And there's one particular Sarah's day that sticks out in my mind. And it was the one when Fiona was most anxious to show us her best Christmas present ever. Not for me. Many things have this Sarah's life, and I feel particularly proud because I stand here and see an independent, attractive, intelligent, stunning young woman. Get it right, sir? I'll go on Wednesday. Do I think you'll agree? And half his parents did get a few things out after all. Oh. Of course, there are other traits that Sarah inherits from me. The brilliant brain, the cooking, the humour, sense of fun, and of course, the allergy to house.
That's why I pay someone.
In John, Sarah's going to turn a corner, and Mark and I are delighted he has become part of the family. Mark and I were well aware that John was the one for Sarah, from a very early stage. As we had become very economical with the truth, especially when her friends rang up and said, "Where's Sarah? What's she doing tonight? Where's she gone?" It was all for the right reasons, however, and I must admit that the first time John came to our house, was Sarah never even happened. John had taken some good courage, but unfortunately,
stilling over.
We always knocked to the wrong house. For thinking he was a leftist, his eyes were so intense. Just remember, John, now that you're married to Sarah, she'll always have the last word in the argument. Any word that you come out with afterwards is by default, the start of the next song. And as a great philosopher once said, a man who gives in when he's wrong is a wise man. But a man who gives in when he's right is still wrong. One of the observations I have to make is that in a recent study carried out to establish whether married men live longer than bachelors, they found out that actually there is no difference. It just seems longer than women. I've been married for, 39 years, 7 months, 6 days. Hey. I feel that I'm in a position to offer Sarah and John some timely advice. Give and take. That's the secret of a happy marriage. Give and take. These are the key words. The wife gives the orders and John. I have to say that Sarah was more than a little apprehensive about me what I might say today, but I hope I haven't done anything or said anything yet to embarrass her. But being Sarah's dad, I have many memories of her as a baby. I've seen her be sick. I've seen her wet herself. Swimming around the floor. And now that I'm at the end of this speech, there is a confession that cannot be made public, and one that I'm sure Sarah knows nothing about. I foolishly decided that I would park right next to an ocean. And then in my wish to help the site, I decided to assist Margaret in dropping them in the ocean.
You dropped the
dress? And I think that Amy and Kim were then absolutely amazed to see how calmly Margaret reacted.
Oh,
they went silent. In fact, Margaret was like a screaming the dresses were ruined, the wedding would have been cancelled, and better still, we were going to leave the homes.
Better still.
I think I might read up this as well, so I'm a little nervous. For the fifth time, I've got a warm seat with a bit of paper behind it.
I'm doing this these days, so I think I'll have a look at every act and have this speaking problem is your own. You just say, well, this is all.
Cheers.